Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So students, now we are going to deal with a study related to the graphical representation of the first order reaction. There are many graphs that could be obtained, but we are going to study four graphical representation based on concentration with respect to time, or with the concentration with respect to rate. So what are those? Let us see. So let me give you the first graph, that is the graph of rate versus the concentration. So in this case, the formula can be written as rate is equals to minus dA divided by dt is equals to k of at plus 0. In this thing, the rate acts like y, while this k acts like m, this at acts like x, while 0 acts like a constant. So it makes a straight line graph that we know as y is equals to mx plus c. So let us see how does this graph looks. So this is the graph of the first one, that is the graph of rate versus concentration. So this is the rate, which is present at y-axis. At, that is concentration after time t, which is present at x-axis, while the m, that is slope, which is acted by the constant k. And since there is no intercept, means the intercept, that is value of c, is 0, as we can see there is no intercept in this region, so it will pass through the origin. So this is the graph of the first one. So now let us see the graph of the second one. Which is graph of concentration versus time. If I draw a graph of concentration versus time, so I will get an equation like at is equals to a0 into exponent raised to minus k upon t. So since at is present on y-axis and time will be present on x-axis, and in this case the graph will be an exponent, means as the time increases the value of at, and in this case at means the amount of the reaction that is remain unreacted will not be decreased, which means the reaction will go on further increasing. As the value of at decreases, it means the reaction is been proceeding ahead. So this will be the graph of concentration and time. So now let us see the third graph. Which is graph of log of a t versus time. Since we know the equation of first since we know the integrated law for the first order reaction as k is equals to 2.303 divided by t log of a0 divided by at, I could make this equation as log of a0, which is division of in at, as you can see at is in denominator, I could write it in this way, log of a0 minus log of at is equals to kt divided by 2.303, and I could arrange this equation as log of at is equals to log of a0 minus kt divided by 2.303. So this equation is very resembling to the straight line equation that we know. This acts like y, while this k divided by 2.303 acts like m, this t will be the x-axis, while log of ac will be the constant. As you can see, the slope, that is m, is in negative, so we could find the slope is going negative words, and instead of y we could see 80. Instead of x, on the x-axis we could see time, and hence we have got the graph, that is log of 80 versus time. So let us see how does it looks. So this is the graph that we have observed, where log of 80 is on the y-axis, the time which is on the x-axis, and the slope which is act like, which is negative, which is k divided by 2.303, and the intercept that we have observed will be nothing but log of A0, or the initial concentration of the reactant. So these are the three graphs that we have observed, and the remaining last one is graph of log of A0 divided by 80 versus time. Again, it's a very simple equation that we know, that is k is equal to 2.303 divided by t log of A0 divided by 80. And to evaluate in the format of a straight line equation, we could make it as log of A0 divided by 80 is equals to kt divided by 2.303 plus 0. So this will make this factor as y, while again k divided by 2.303 will be acting like the slope, t will be on the x-axis, and in this case the constant will be 0. So since the constant is 0, means we won't find an intercept and the line will be passed through the origin. So let us see how does this graph looks. So this is the graph where we have estimated that on y-axis there will be log of A0 divided by 80, on x-axis there will be time, and the slope will be k divided by 2.303, and it will pass through the origin. So these were the four graphs which was based on the first order of reaction. So I hope you have understood each and every graph. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and please don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.